What's up, everybody? Welcome to the inaugural episode of Alcohol Analysts, AA meeting numero uno. Today we'll be taking a look at the newest member of the Guinness family, the Guinness Blonde. I'm gonna try that out today, let you know what we think. We'll also be making and trying Beast Mode Vodka in honor of the Seahawks, go 12th man. And at the end of the show, stay tuned because we'll be giving out $100 in BevMo gift cards. Run the intro. What's up, everybody? Welcome to Alcohol Analysts. This is our AA meeting number one. Today we're going to be taking a look at the new Guinness Blonde American Lager. Since this is our first episode, we'll go ahead and just run through who we are and I guess what kind of drinkers we're known as. I'm Tommy. I guess I would say I'm a social drinker. I drink if I'm out and about, but it's not. I don't even drink every day. So that's me.
I'm Jason. I just like to drink.
I'm Max. Not a big drinker. Don't really like doing it. These guys force me to do it, so.
And I'm Jordan. I do not drink at all.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and crack these open. Guinness Blonde. Doesn't smell bad, actually. It smells pretty good to me.
Yeah, I think it's a great smell, honestly.
Okay.
I'm excited.
It smells like Uncle's breath at a barbecue.
It smells like stomachache waiting to happen for me.
Mm-hmm. Is that what it feels like?
Yeah, this Guinness Blonde is the first of the Discovery series. They'll be releasing two every year. Unlike the original made in Dublin, this one's made right here in the States.
All right, let's go ahead and get our taste test try. On. Get our taste-a-roo.
Is that what we do?
All at once? Mmm. Definitely can say, not a big beer drinker.
Jordan, did you swallow this?
This doesn't hit the spot, that's for sure. Not for me, at least, you know.
I'd rather have my soda, to be honest with you guys.
I think we should probably chill our beers from now on. This is the first episode, so...
They're semi-chilled.
Yeah, it could be a little colder. But even for being slightly warm, it's not bad.
I really like it, honestly. It's light. The yeast is bread-like.
I don't know how you guys do it.
I'm a fan.
Yeah.
I'm not...
A hint of citrus?
Citrus? We're talking about orange juice.
Yeah, dude.
No.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of Guinness, the original. It's a little too thick, but Guinness Blonde, I could definitely roll with this. Mm-hmm. It's nice and light, like a lager typically is and should be. I would definitely recommend this.
Was it like fizzy when you guys like? Was it like sparkling water? Because that's what I felt it was like. I'm not a fan of
beer, and that's gonna be on every beer.
Okay, yeah, I wasn't a fan of the sparkling water, bubbly stuff there.
Yeah.
Nah, that
carbonation. It would get you.
I don't see where you guys got the citrus from.
Did you guys recommend this beer? Would you recommend this beer?
I would definitely recommend this beer. It's definitely like a summer barbecue beer, I'd say. You're outside grilling, cooking. Someone passed me a Guinness Blonde.
I would also recommend this beer. It's like have a good time with your. You're gonna have to cut that.
I wouldn't really recommend it to anyone, but I'm not a big beer drinker, and you know,
it's gonna be a pass for me. I'm gonna stick with my soda on this one. If this is at a party,
yeah. If you're at a party, it's definitely not a beer drinking game.
I would play drinking games with this beer,
but you're just wild.
Yeah, I feel like this is a little too much for me. I'd say, you know, pass me something a little more light. This, if I'm at home after a long day sitting down, having a beer.
This is actually really good.
Yeah, I would definitely drink it. Party games, beer pong, I don't think I would.
On a scale of 0 to 5 mugs, what would you guys rate this?
I would definitely say a 4. It's really good to me. I would definitely drink this out. I said 4 mugs.
But you wouldn't play a drinking game with it?
No. I would typically play drinking games with like a 2.
That's
a
really two strange.
Oh, like...
I'm going to also give it a 4. I think it's great, and I would drink this anytime, all
it's
the time,
definitely,
game
it's,
or not.
It's drinkable, but I feel like after 3, I would be, like, full. That's just me.
Debatable.
Pratt?
I'll give it a 2. It's not terrible. You know, I can sip it without you being like, oh, okay, okay. And I don't like beer.
But I wouldn't expect very high ratings from
these guys. I'll give it a 2. And that's pretty good.
That's more than I thought it would be.
Yeah. I'm going to give it a 1. It's not horrible, but I'd rather have my soda. That's me.
Soda.
I think Jordan drank more of his beer than Max did.
Yeah.
I've definitely been drinking mine.
I wanted a good opinion.
You said they're coming out with 2 different beers a year from Guinness now?
They are.
Are they all gonna be from
every
America?
Year. I don't know if they're all going to be from America. This is the first of the Discovery series, so they're just going to release a new beer, they said, twice every year.
Nice. That's definitely something I'm looking forward to, because this is definitely...
This is the landmark.
Maybe I'll like that one better.
Is this your favorite beer you've ever had?
A nice American beer.
No.
Definitely not my favorite beer.
Wow, so you've had some good stuff then, because you gave out, like, you're talking it up.
It's really good.
He likes it.
It is really good. Definitely not my favorite. So overall, you know, Guinness Blonde is a hit for me. Really think it's a really nice beer.
I agree.
Even at the other less drinking side of the table, they seem to enjoy it a little bit. It's definitely a good beer. So now we're going to take a look at Beast Mode Vodka. To honor our Seahawks. Basically, if you don't know what Beast Mode Vodka is, it is Skittles and vodka. Take a look at us making it.
All right, we had a little Skittle. Get the vodka. Someone tell me when.
Prayers.
Then it's ready.
Turn and handle into left side.
And, within us, you know, we believe that we can do it.
Finds a little bit of a hole, keeps his legs moving. He's across the 40, midfield, 45, he's on the run, Lynch. 40, pushes the man, 35, look at him go. He's down to 20, 15, he could go. He is going to go. Touchdown, Seahawks.
Here, let's get a close-up on this. Now, if you're going to make it, I recommend only using...
The green Skittles.
The green Skittles and the blue Skittles and separate them. We didn't know that, and we just put half a bag in here. And this is what we got.
I mean, it is what it is.
I'm sure it tastes great, but aesthetics, not good at all. There's chunks floating. It's brown.
How long has this been sitting?
About 20 minutes. We're going to go ahead and try this for you, let you know how it tastes.
I'm a little nervous, honestly.
I've actually tried Beast Mode Vodka before. Someone else made it, and it looked a lot better than this.
I've never had it.
So, I don't know how this one's going to taste.
It smells like Skittles, honestly. It smells like straight up, maybe a little kick to it, but it's pretty Skittly.
We need a rag
on it. It's got a lot of spunk to it.
it's got some spunk.
All right, very thick. I think when it sits there, it just gets...
Oh my gosh, you guys both went for it.
All right, without any further ado, let's go ahead and try this Beast Mode Vodka. Cheers to the Seahawks advancing to the next level of the playoffs.
NFC Championship.
NFC Championship. Woo! Super Bowl Dynasty, 2 years in a row. Cheers. Go Hawks. I forgot that there were Skittles at the bottom of this.
I didn't get any
Mine's
Skittles.
Stuck.
Oh god, I don't like it. It's down.
You drank it?
I don't like it.
Can I start first? Is that alright?
Yeah, go for it.
I already started.
I like Beast Mode Vodka. I thought that was interesting. For the crappy, maybe I shouldn't say crappy. The cheap vodka that we used, it didn't seem to really matter.
Yeah, it definitely took the edge off of that cheap. It really was the cheapest vodka we could find at the store when we made this, and it definitely made it taste a lot better. It's definitely thicker, though, than a typical shot. It's
very sweet. It leaves, like, a sticky feeling on your lips like you just ate a bunch of candy.
That's what that is.
It's really sweet. I wouldn't recommend putting the Skittles in the bottom of the shot glass.
Choke? Mine got
definitely
stuck.
Definitely a choke hazard. I almost choked. I think your guys are stuck.
Mine's stuck.
Mine's stuck.
I didn't go for it, so, you know.
So, I think it's a good shot. I wouldn't recommend doing it every touchdown it might get.
A little redundant.
A little overkill. And not being able to taste the vodka so much is always a dangerous situation to be in.
True.
What did you, Jordan, was that your first shot?
That was my first shot. That was the first time ever having vodka.
Hard alcohol ever.
And I don't not know correct. What to think about that at all. I might like the Guinness Blonde a little bit more than that. I'd rather drink that any day over that.
I'm excited to see the playback on that one.
Oh, we'll get to that.
I forgot that there were Skittles at the bottom of this.
I didn't get any mine Skittles. Stuck. Oh, God. I don't like it.
So, would you drink it again?
Would I drink this again?
Yeah.
I'll probably say no.
No. Prack, were you? That's did okay. you drink it, Prack?
I took a little sippy sip.
Did you swallow
it? I mean, I spit it out.
That's right.
It wasn't bad. Like, I could taste the sugary Skittles in there, but kind of numbed my mouth a little bit. Wasn't bad, though.
Interesting.
Wasn't bad.
I think it just shocked me. Because this is my first time.
Yeah, being your first shot, hey, it was a good beast mode.
Yep.
For your first one, not bad, because if I had to throw my game in there,
hey,
it's probably not a bad choice, because straight, it would have been a lot worse.
Okay. All right. Yeah, so I
guarantee that.
So it's just looking up from here, pretty much.
Kind of looking down.
The moment you guys all been waiting for?
The announcement of our contest. We're going to be giving away $100 in BevMo gift cards.
Four cards, $25 a piece.
We'll be giving them away via YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook.
And on YouTube for a chance to win. Like this video, comment on this video, and
subscribe
to our channel.
Subscribe is the word you're looking for. On Twitter, all you got to do is follow us and retweet is the word I'm looking for. Retweet our last photo. About the contest.
Facebook, you just gotta like our page, leave a comment on our page.
Yeah, and we're gonna be randomly picking a winner from each of our social media sites at random. And then we'll hit you up for your email and we'll get those gift cards to you. Contest ends on the 25th, and we will be announcing the winners on Monday the 26th. That will be AA meeting number 3. So stay tuned. Subscribe, and get in for this contest. Go Hawks.
We love you all.
Thanks for sticking through on the very first episode of Alcohol Analyst. We're out. Today we're going to be taking a look at
Pabst Blue Ribbon, and also
Albertson's Whiskey.